Yes. Yes, simple answer. There are literally hundreds of diseases that have been associated with changes in the microbiome. It's been really hard to tell whether or not those associations are causal or whether they're just happening, they're just sort of hitching a ride on whatever else is happening in your body, right? So is the microbiome different because the environment in your body is different when you're sick? Or was there a change in the microbiome that somehow precipitated a disease state? This is very hard to tell for most things. For clustered and difficile infections, we know the causal role there. But for a lot of other diseases, it's harder and harder to say. Starting with cancer, there's a few examples where, actually recent examples, very exciting examples, where there does appear to be a connection between the microbiome and cancer. So with colorectal cancer, for example, it does seem that there are certain organisms that are normally very rare in the gut, like Fusobacterium is one of them, and a few others. I think they're often present in the mouth, but they're very rare in the gut. But they seem to be able to colonize polyps in the intestine. So oftentimes when you go for a colonoscopy, those of you who are a little older who go for colonoscopies, sometimes they'll snip the polyps. These are sort of precancerous little protrusions that they get rid of just to be safe. But these polyps are microenvironments that allow for the colonization of something like a Fusobacterium, which settles down and then forms a biofilm on that polyp. And at least in a mouse model, they've shown that these biofilms, these microbial biofilms, actually produce metabolites that can feed into oncogenesis or the induction of cancer. So in mice, at the very least, we have shown that colorectal cancer does have a causal link to this Fusobacterium colonization. It's been messier in humans. It's not as clear in humans that is the case, but I would guess there is some sort of feedback role between those changes in the microbiome and colorectal cancer. Other than that, there's a huge connection between the microbiome and the immune system. We know that there's feedback in both directions, from the immune system to the microbiome, and from the microbiome to the immune system, and recent ways of treating cancer have really begun to rely upon the immune system. So treatments for cancer that use the immune system to attack the cancer, it has been shown that differences in people's microbiomes actually affect the outcomes of those treatments. So these treatments are more effective in some patients that have certain types of microbes in their guts. And a very, very recent paper, this was in mice, so again, it's not humans, but in mice, they found an 11-species consortium of bacteria that they could grow and feed into another mouse. They found that when they applied these cancer immunotherapies to these mice, they found the efficacy of the immunotherapy with this 11-bug cocktail was improved significantly. So perhaps the future of cancer treatment might go hand in hand with engineering the microbiome and the immune system to kind of work in concert to attack and resolve the cancer. So that's for cancer, but you know, I could spend all day talking about the hundreds of other diseases in which the microbiome has been implicated. You know, we know that a lot of what we eat, a lot of the complex plant molecules in our diets, we don't have the genes to break those down. We can't break down fiber ourselves. Even like the polysaccharides in breast milk, for example, when we're babies, a lot of those polysaccharides that mom puts in the breast milk, we can't eat them. They're specifically food for our microbes. But the breakdown products of some of those polysaccharides actually make their way into our bloodstream. So we can measure the metabolism of our microbiome in our blood metabolome. And we're just starting to kind of decouple and understand how different types of microbiota modulate this blood metabolic signature for each of us for a given diet.